bo ni bi osu meta si gbayi a ma mu orilede a ma mu oludari orilede tutun awon kan so bi asiko Buhari ya ibi ti pa wa o ya je wa o se ta wa o te ni o se telu awon mi so bi Buhari kan le bi a ka se fatiku awon odomode ni bi a ka se fun soore ṣùgbọ́n kí ló dúwà tẹ̀fẹ́ hàn yín nípa ìbò nàìjíríà tó ń bọ̀ kí lè rò pé àwọn èèyàn ọlọ́run gbọ́dọ̀ ṣe láti lè lórí tó dà ǹjẹ́ Buhari ǹjẹ́ ibi tó gbé wa lọ ǹjẹ́ ibi rere ni.
ṣẹ́dírí gan tí mo lè sọ tẹ́mi mọ́ bá mi sọ màkàkólì ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ta èlìtàwúmẹ́tàwúntakùn àwọn ènìyàn wọ́n ti gbé ìṣúra wọn lé ènìyàn lọ́wọ́ wọn ò fi ètò ṣe ìṣúra wọn sínú ọgá ògo mọ they have allowed a man to cancel them they don't wait upon the counsel of God anymore that is why you see things that is happen apart and apart you see that things is just not going straight in Nigeria and people now be crying it's not the will of God for us to cry it's not the will of God for us to murmur it's not the will of God for us to suffering but you know when man does not do the will of God that is why you see us facing the challenges we are not in the will of God anymore a se ife olorun mo ati ko ninu ife olorun ati ko ninu ore ofe olorun ati ko ninu ma je mo olorun nitori e loluwa se wa nlu eniyan na wa legba
o fi eniyan na wa legba
beni tori pe beni o so ninu gbe oro re ninu gbe jeremiah o so pe eni keni to ba gbekele eniyan òhun yóò sì lu ènìyàn láti ṣe kí ni láti nà á ní ẹgbà ẹ tó bá gbẹ́kẹ̀lé ènìyàn tó bá sọ di ọlọ́run rẹ̀ òhun yóò fi ènìyàn tó gbẹ́kẹ̀lé láti ṣe kí ni láti dojú ìjà kọ́ nítorí pé o ti sọ ènìyàn di òrìṣà
ìyàn ọlọ́run fúnra rẹ̀ ni
bẹ́ẹ̀ ni when we read the book of Matthew Psalm 91 he was there ó sọ pé èmi ju òrìṣà kékèké lọ ipe mi olúwa ni mo tún dá wọn ọlọ́run ló dá òrìṣà ló dá ọ̀bàtálá ọlọ́run ló dá gbogbo àwọn agbára tí wọ́n dá àwọn ènìyàn láwìn oṣóni àjẹni olóògbóni ni ọlọ́run ló dá wọn òun ló dá òkùnkùn ṣùgbọ́n ó sọ pé ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá ti wá pa má jẹ̀mú wọn ọlọ́run mọ́ òun máa wá jẹ́ kí àwọn òkùnkùn máa nà wọ́n lẹ́gbàá torí ẹ lè ṣe rí wípé olúwa lo Buhari láti na orílẹ̀-èdè yìí lẹ́gbàá bẹ́ẹ̀ni nítorí pé àwọn ènìyàn ò ṣe ìfẹ́ ọlọ́run people don't do the will of God Buhari himself want to the God has put his fear in his heart to do his will but we now depend on Buhari we don't want to serve God again.
So àgbẹ̀ ògbó ìṣòro alẹ́ Buhari ló.
Yes, we put all our hope we put it on Buhari and we are thinking that he is going to do good he is going to favour us and God now turn the heart of Buhari are you there with him to strike Nigeria. Because we are putting all our hope all our universe all everything about us we are putting it upon this man. But the only thing he said to me this man is going to, a second time again.
Ṣé kò tún máa wọlé báyìí?
Ó máa wọlé.
Ǹjẹ́ ìyá yẹn ò ní pọ̀ báyìí?
Ṣùgbọ́n gẹ́gẹ́ bí májèmọ́ Ọlọ́run the Lord said to me I saw things changes in the hand of God not in the hand of man. Because the Lord said to me, he said, when Nigeria can willingly and return to their God, he said he's going to heal Nigeria.
Totally.
By himself. It's in the book of Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. When we read that message, he said, where we can obedient, where you can willingly. And return, he said, we shall eat the fruit of the land. We shall eat the fruit of the land. Because most of us, we don't want to come back to God again. That is why you see everything that is happened.
For you say if I tiku abi any body abi show re Buhari no lulu atun gbebo se ko kawa ti pe kokolo joko sunu oko ni abi kokolo wa commission
God says it's going to be Buhari. I said the Lord is not talking. He said the Lord is not what?
He's not talking, sir.
Look at it. The only thing we need to do in Nigeria, as Nigeria say, oh, when you want God to change Buhari, it does not move God to change Buhari. It's for we to return back to our God. to return back in our wicked way. To return back in our evil way.
From our evil way?
Yes. To return back to God. Let pastor repent. Let shepherd repent. Let the one that call himself king, let him repent. The one of 419, the wicked one, you call yourself a drug dealer, repent. You call yourself a source of name, repent. Look at it. Look at what God says in the word of the in say in the book of Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. The book of Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. This is what the Holy Spirit said to me now. Marinta wulia makakulia sheta. He said something to me. He said, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. If Nigeria can willingly,
they will eat.
They will eat the good of the land.
They are only obedient.
If they are obedient to God, if they come to God, if they ask for mercy, and they return from their evil way, they will eat the good of the land, the good of Nigeria. That is why are we rushing going to overseas? Shebi, it's because of our economy.
No bad, no bad.
Look at it.
House
rent. Oh, one.
What you?
Look at what is happening.
You will have to joke with the church.
No, rice is gone.
Rice is gone. Gari gone, sir.
I want a lot. Go and be one. All the shiri shiri shere.
Fuck bogunti. I want a lot. I want a lot. All
the shiri shiri. Tabale okuro ni no amon iwa bajewa. Eh? Oluwa so wipe a o jere ile na a o de si je furugun ile na tori pe a fe yi para si Olorun a yi para si eniyan. We want to please God. We want to please God. You that want to please your husband, he will make your husband to turn against you. You husband that you want your wife to please you, you don't want your wife to please God, he will let your wife to strike you. You wife that you don't please God, or you don't want you wife, I'm telling you, hear me, it can be abroad, it can be Nigeria, you don't want your wife to please God, you that husband, you don't want your wife to read the word of God, you don't want your wife to be born again, you will see that your wife, it will be the one to kill you, because you don't want that your wife to do the will of God. You wife that you don't want your husband to do the will of God, and you want to be doing me and my husband alone. At the end of it, that your husband, you could be the one that will kill you. We always see it in social media, we see it on Facebook. But when you can allow God to take place in that home, and let God direct that home, and let that home be the house of what? Be the house of worship. Be the house of righteousness. Be the house of faithfulness. Look at the word of God. In that word, there is a something I see. There is a silence that I see in that message. In the book of Ezra chapter 1, verse 19, look at what God said to Israel. He was talking to Israel. He said, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. If you are willing, when you are willing, you want your husband to serve God. You husband, you want your wife to serve God. You will see the God will let what you are labor for, you will eat it in your old age. You will eat it in your old age. You will don't need to call a fake prophet again. You will not need to call any pastor to pray for you. Where you can willingly, Pastor does not want anybody to cancel him or her. They want to be saying that God called me, I am a shepherd, I am the leader of the church. When you are a shepherd or you are a pastor, where you don't willingly
allow God
to take place, God will use a man to strike them.
If they don't allow God to manifest and teach them.
Yes, now, when you don't allow God to manifest,
yes,
and teach them His way, His new covenant, are you there with
yes,
me?
Sir.
When they don't willingly simply means where you can obey. Look at it in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. He said, "Where you can willingly obey dance and keep my statutes, I will take you above of what? Above of the world. I will take you above of the king. You will eat with king. King will come to your house to eat. You will not suffer. You will not beg for food in the hand of king. But because we don't willingly to serve God again, we don't willingly to tarry, that is why we get frustrated. You see a two family, they get frustrated by they don't will and to surrender. They don't want to submit. They don't want to calm down to God. They don't want to give their life to God. That is why you see what is happening to them. They are fighting today and tomorrow. There is no solution. The solution is this. Is in the book of Isaiah chapter 1 verse Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19. It has already told us. That is what I have been telling us. He said, if you are willingly and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. When we can willingly, when we can obedient, we shall eat the good of the land. If you want to eat the good of the land in that America that you are, willingly, let me tell you the meaning. Number one, you must be born again. Number two, you must to keep the commandment of God. Number three, you must to love your neighbor. Number four, you must to forgive and let go. Because in the book of Matthew chapter 18, when you scroll it down, he said, anyone that is not forgive his brother, he said, I, the Lord, will not forgive in sin. Because most of us, we don't know how to forgive. That is another thing. That is what makes people to face some challenges when you cannot forgive. Unforgiving is a spirit. It's an evil spirit. Unforgiving. When you cannot forgive, there will be storm in your house. When you don't love, there will be storm in that your business. When you cannot forgive your wife, maybe your wife sinned against you. Because of that, you leave home and then you go and be sleeping with another woman out there. You two, you have committed adultery.
And join another woman.
Yes. That's why you see some people, because their woman, they see their woman doing rubbish, maybe their woman doing fornication. For them to settle, they will not settle. They will go and be fornicate. For them to divorce, they will not divorce. They will know that what that woman will collect from them, it will be equal. It will be equal.
Yes, very huge.
Uh-huh. It will be very huge. And they don't want to divorce that woman.
Alimony case.
And for you to be seen out there, you too, you have committed adultery. You man. You woman, that you see yourself, that you see your husband that is fornicate. Because of that, you too want to do the same.
No, you want to retaliate.
They want to start it as competition.
Yes, sir.
You are fornicate. You will have fornicate. That's what to say. So you will see, the family will not be shaking. That boat will not be shaking. Except they give their life to Christ. When they want to give their life to Christ, it's in the book of Rome chapter 10, starting from verse 10. He says something there that make me to sober. That make me to so what?
Sober.
Rome chapter 10. Let me read it. Rome chapter 10, verse 10. He says something in that room. Let us listen. Rome chapter 10. And let us start it from verse 9 to 10. Rome chapter 10, verse 9 to 10. He said that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God have raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Verse 10. For with the heart one believes to righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made to righteousness.
And salvation.
To salvation. When you can confess Lord Jesus with your heart, when you can confess him, he will make as your righteousness. Because he said in the book of Rome chapter 8 verse 1, he said, therefore, now, no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who are not walking according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. When you give your life to Christ, when this family that I'm talking to, where you are in overseas, where you are in Nigeria, where you are in any country, any challenges you are facing, You use your hand to cause it because there is no Jesus in that home. There is no new covenant in that home. When you want a new covenant to start in that home, accept Jesus. Don't look for prophet again. Don't look for teacher again. What you need Jesus. Jesus is a new covenant. Because when you accept Jesus, your house will take another shape. Another shape of what? Another shape of new covenant. When you want to give your life to Christ, when you know that you don't have Jesus, repeat after me. Because there is no time. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy upon me. Forgive me, Lord Jesus Christ. I accepted you today as my Lord, as my personal Savior. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy upon me. Forgive me my iniquity. Lord Jesus Christ, me and my household, we come to a new covenant of Jesus today so that we can be free from the devil, so that our business can have another turnaround. Lord Jesus, have your way in our family. Thank you, Jesus, for saving us. Thank you, Jesus, for rescuing us. Thank you, Jesus, for giving us a new glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Let me pray for you, oh Jesus. Heavenly Father, I pray for those that give their life to Christ. As you hear this word, I pray the Lord will turn your family to another shape in the name of Jesus. The covenant of Jesus, it will be upon your home in the name of Jesus. As you give your life to Christ, your life will not remain the same again in the name of Jesus. The power of the mighty God, it will be upon your home in the name of Jesus. Every storm in your family, I say there should be stopped in the name of Jesus. I call upon the blood of Jesus Christ. I call the blood of Jesus Christ into that house, into that heart, into that family. I say the blood of Jesus Christ, it should turn everything the devil has spoiled in that body in the name of Jesus Christ. Your home will receive a peace of God in the name of Jesus. Your business will receive a peace of God in the name of Jesus. Your sickness, that sickness you have, because you have given your life to Christ, it is no longer there again in the name of Jesus. A new covenant of Jesus, it has been in that body. Thank you, Father. I pray with you, we shall make heaven together in the name of Jesus. But when God tarry, we shall do well in everywhere we are in the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious God. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. When you want